Jesse Tway here, and today I'm going to be bringing you guys what is, in my opinion, the best 100k team on FIFA 16 Ultimate Team. Now, this team right here is in the 4-3-3 third variation formation. It's one of the first times I've used it this year in one of my squad builders on my channel, and this team here is amazing. I have previously done a best 100k team, and that had James Rodriguez, David Silva, and I believe Jackson Martinez, but this team here, it's even better than that. It has got one of the highest rated players on the game. A certain Swedish PSV striker does feature in the team. But yeah, it's a very, very good team. It's got some very high rated players in. It has got some very, very good players in. So without further ado, let's go on into the team. So starting off in goal in the 100k team, we've got Benaglio. He is 6'4", which is very, very good. He's also got really good diving and good reflexes, and he will cost you discard price, which is very good. He is a very, very good keeper on the game. Left back position, we've got Zuniga. You can actually use any left back you want in the Serie A, but I decided to go with him because he's got very good pace, very good dribbling, really good passing as well, so he's very good going forwards, but defensively he's got good defending and good physical as well, and 4-star skills, which is very rare for a fullback, and high medium work rates, which is what I prefer the most really for my fullbacks. Next to him in the centre back position, we have got Leandro Castan, 6 foot tall, medium high work rates, which is what I like on most defenders. They need to be over 6 foot, and they need to have medium high work rates if you want them to be a really kind of top class defender. It's very, very important for them to stay back whilst attacking like that. Now he's got 72 pace as well, which is awesome. Over 70 pace is key for defenders really this year, and also he does have 80 forward defending and 80 physical, which is not too bad right there. Next to him, we've got one of my favourite defenders this year, and that is Naldo. Now, the reason I like him so much, despite him having high medium work rates, and I did just say that I really like medium high work rates for defenders, but the reason I like using him is he is 6'6", and he is absolutely massive. He's got 88 defending. He's going to win absolutely every header. No one can really beat him in the air. He's great off corners. He will get you goals from corners. He did actually get me a goal in the 4 games I have played with the team. Now, I will have gameplay from more than 4 games to show you guys. But, yeah, for the purposes of doing the video, I wanted to get one out today because, yeah, it's quite late on already today. It's it's just gone past 8 o'clock. I need to make a video. So I decided to quickly do this squad builder right here of a team that I've been using recently, which I've been very, very much enjoying using. But yeah, Naldo, he's got good pace, good defending, and amazing physical as well. Very, very tall, and he's a very good defender for just 3,000 coins. And to complete the defense, we've got Dani Alves in the right-back position, one of the best right-backs on the game. He's got amazing, well-balanced stats. As I have said previously, I like fullbacks who are good going forwards, and he has got plenty of very good attacking stats. He's got over 70 for shooting, passing, very, very good pace as well, 86, really good dribbling as well, and good defending and physical. He will cost you around 6,000 coins, so he's quite expensive, but yeah, it's a 100k team, so I thought I would fit in some quite expensive players in the defense, so that I would have a very solid defense. So I was originally just going to try and build a team around quite a very expensive player, maybe kind of an 80 or 90,000 coin player, but what I wanted to do was really kind of build a team full of good players, and that is what I've done right here. Now moving into the midfield, we start off in the right defensive midfield position with Luka Modric. In my opinion, he is probably the best centre mid on the game, and as a defensive midfielder, he is also very good. He got me 2 assists in 4 games, and looking at his stats, he's got amazing stats. 89 dribbling, 84 passing, and also good pace and really, really good shooting as well. He's got great long shots, 4-star skills, 4-star weak foot, and yeah, he is probably my favourite centre mid on the game. He's amazing at passing. One of the best kind of creative midfielders I've used on this game. In the left defensive midfield position, we've got Daniel Rossi. I used him in an unbeatable 10,000 coin team that I did do yesterday, and he's an amazing defensive midfielder. He's actually become one of my favourite defensive midfielders on the game. He's got medium high work rate, 6'1", and just defensively, he's amazing. He's got great defending and great physical. He's very cheap as well, and he got me 3 goals there in the 12 games. In the middle of the pitch, we've got Kovacic. Now, he's 78 rated. He's a low rated player, really, for a 100k team, but he is a very, very good player, and that's why he is in the team. Now, a lot of people actually prefer him to Modric, and I know Nepenthes especially really, really likes using him. He rates him as one of the best centre mids on the game, and in my opinion as well, he's an amazing player. One of my favourite cheap centre mids. I mean, he's very, very similar to Modric. He's quicker, he's not got the shooting, but he's got very, very similar passing and dribbling stats. He's got 4-star skills and 4-star weak foot as well, and medium work rates is very, very good for a centre mid in this position. because he's just going to stay there and be a very good kind of pivotal player that you can pass to. He's going to really distribute the play and be a very, very good player in that position. And he did get me one goal in four games as well. Moving into the Strikeforce left wing position, we have got El Shaarawy. Now, this actually is Monaco card. He did play not very well for Monaco in real life. I think he did then go to Roma because they didn't actually want to sign him. And basically, he had a contract where Monaco would actually have to buy him if he played 25 games with them. So once he played 24 games, he just stayed on the bench. And then Roma did buy him, and he's been playing very, very well for Roma. But this is his card at Monaco. 4-star skills and 4-star weak foot, which is always good. 86 pace, 84 dribbling, and good shooting and passing too, which is, always good. And he's getting me one assist in four games, which is not too bad for a winger. And he will cost you around 2,000 coins. In the right wing position, we've got one of my favourite wingers on the game, and someone who I never really knew was this cheap until I used him. I mean, it's the first time I've used him right here, and he's amazing. As you can see by his goals per game ratio there, two assists and one goal in four games is very, very good for a winger. And 1.6k paid for him. 4-star skill moves yet again. I think we've already managed to fit 4 4-star skills into the team, which is pretty good. 93 pace, 87 dribbling, 73 shooting, 75 passing. Lucas is an absolutely amazing right winger, and I know a lot of other big YouTubers do rate him quite highly. I know Bateson rates him as a very, very good winger, and in my opinion, he is one of the best wingers I've actually used this year. And to complete the team, we have got the main man, Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Now, this is actually his loan card, and all of the previous games that I played with him before using him in this team, he came on for like the last 10 minutes when I was losing and didn't get any goals. So he has played four games and got three goals and one assist, which is a good return for a striker. And yeah, he was a lot of fun to use. He's got amazing finishing. Literally everything in the penalty area, he will finish off. Now, this is a loan card, but he will cost you around 58,000 coins. I think that's what I last saw his price as. I think that was yesterday, and I'm going to be buying him once he does run out of contracts and putting him into the team, because this team here was so good to use, and Ibrahimovic really, really was a clinical striker. He finished everything in the area. I mean, he's got 90 shooting, so you'd expect him to just finish everything. He's 6'5" as well, so he wins everything in the air. He's also got 86 physical, 85 dribbling, which is very good. 81 passing as well is great. 73 pace is not bad either. And 4-star skills and 4-star weak foot, the same as a lot of the other players in the team. But he was a very good player. A lot of fun to use. He's very strong. He'll push people off the ball. If only he had 5-star skills, he would just be even better. But for some reason, he does not have 5-star skills, despite being a very, very skillful player in real life. But this is the Finnish team. Now, I really liked the defense because I had one relatively quick, very good at defending centre-back right here, but who had medium-high work rate, so he'd stay back. Then I had Naldo, who was just a massive player in the air. He'd win every header, and he's just a massive tank, really. He is very, very big in-game. You will see, if you do use him, just how big he is. He's 6'6", but he's also very wide, and it's almost as if he has kind of a ring around him, and if someone gets into that ring, they're not going to be getting past him, because if you just spam B, he's just going to be able to push them off the ball, and no one is going to get past him. Dani Alves and Zuniga, very, very good going forwards, and very, very good defensively. They're probably the two best attacking fullbacks that you can use, and I personally like using attacking fullbacks, but I do set them to stay back whilst attacking so they get back, but then when I need to attack with them, I can attack. Defensive midfielders, very, very good as well, and obviously the strike force was amazing with Ibrahimovic up front. That is the team. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, smash the like, subscribe new, and I'll see you in my next video. Take care. Moving into the Strike Force left wing position, we have got El Shaarawy. Now, this actually is Monaco card. He did play not very well for Monaco in real life. I think he did then go to Roma because they didn't actually want to sign him. And basically, he had a contract where Monaco would actually have to buy him if he played 25 games for them. So once he played 24 games, he just stayed on the bench. And then Roma did buy him, and he's been playing very, very well for Roma. But this is his card at Monaco, 4-star skills and 4-star weak foot, which is always good. 86 pace, 84 dribbling, and good shooting and passing too, which is, always good. And he's getting me one assist in 4 games, which is not too bad for a winger, and he will cost you around 2,000 coins. In the right wing position, we've got one of my favourite wingers on the game, and someone who I never really knew was this cheap until I used him. I mean, it's the first time I've used him right here, and he's amazing. As you can see by his goals per game ratio there, 2 assists and 1 goal in 4 games is very, very good for a winger. And 1.6k I paid for him. 4-star skill moves yet again. I think we've already managed to fit 4-star skills into the team, which is pretty good. 93 pace, 87 dribbling, 73 shooting, 75 passing. Lucas is an absolutely amazing right winger. And I know a lot of other big YouTubers do rate him quite highly. I know Bateson rates him as a very, very good winger. And in my opinion, he is one of the best wingers I've actually used this year. And to complete the team, we've got the main man, Zlatan Ibrahimovic. Now, this is actually his loan card. And all of the previous games that I played with him before using him in this team, he came on for like the last 10 minutes when I was losing and didn't get any goals. So he has played 4 games and got 3 goals and 1 assist, which is a guys, Itoa here, and today I'm going to be bringing you guys what is, in my opinion, the best 100k team on FIFA 16 Ultimate Team. Now, this team right here is in the 4-3-3 third variation formation. It's one of the first times I've used it this year in one of my squad builders on my channel, and this team here is amazing. I have previously done a best 100k team, and that had James Rodriguez, David Silva, and I believe Jackson Martinez, but this team here, it's even better than that. It has got one of the highest rated players on the game, a certain Swedish PSG striker does feature in the team. But it's a very, very good team. It's got some very high rated players in. It has got some very, very good players in. So without further ado, let's go on into the team. So starting off in goal in the 100k team, we've got Benaglio. He is 6'4", which is very, very good. He's also got really good diving and good reflexes, and he will cost you discard price, which is very good. He is a very, very good keeper on the game. Left back position, we've got Zuniga. You can actually use any left back you want in the Serie A, but I decided to go with him because he's got very good pace, very good dribbling, really good passing as well, so he's very good going forwards, but defensively he's got good defending and good physical as well, and 4-star skills, which is very rare for a fullback, and high medium work rates, which is what I prefer the most really for my fullbacks. Next to him in the centre back position, we have got Leandro Castan, 6 foot tall, medium high work rates, which is what I like on most defenders. They need to be over 6 foot, and they need to have medium high work rates if you want them to be a really kind of top class defender. It's very, very important for them to stay back whilst attacking like that. Now he's got 72 pace as well, which is awesome. Over 70 pace is key for defenders really this year, and also he does have 85 defending and 80 physical, which is not too bad right there. Next to him, we've got one of my favourite defenders this year, and that is Naldo. Now, the reason I like him so much, despite him having high medium work rates, and I did just say that I really like medium high work rates for defenders, but the reason I like using him is he is 6'6", and he is absolutely massive. He's got 88 defending. He's going to win absolutely every header. No one can really beat him in the air. He's great off corners. He will get you goals from corners. He did actually get me a goal in the 4 games I have played with the team. Now, I will have gameplay from more than 4 games to show you guys. But, for the purposes of doing the video, I wanted to get one out today because, it's quite late on already today. It's just gone past 8 o'clock. I need to make a video. So I decided to quickly do this squad builder right here of a team that I've been using recently, which I've been very, very much enjoying using. But Naldo, he's got good pace, good defending, and amazing physical as well. Very, very tall, and he's a very good defender for just 3,000 coins. And to complete the defense, we've got Dani Alves in the right-back position, one of the best right-backs on the game. He's got amazing, well-balanced stats. As I have said previously, I like fullbacks who are good going forwards, and he has got plenty of very good attacking stats. He's got over 70 for shooting, passing, very, very good pace as well, 86. Really good dribbling as well, and good defending and physical. He will cost you around 6,000 coins, so he's quite expensive, But yeah, it's a 100k team, so I thought I would fit in some quite expensive players in the defense so that I would have a very solid defense. So I was originally just going to try and build a team around quite a very expensive player, maybe kind of an 80 or 90,000 coin player. But what I wanted to do was really kind of build a team full of good return for a striker. And yeah, he was a lot of fun to use. He's got amazing finishing. Literally everything in the penalty area he will finish off. Now this is a loan card, but he will cost you around 58,000 coins. I think that's what I last saw his price as. I think that was yesterday. And I'm going to be buying him once he does run out of contracts and putting him into the team, because this team here was so good to use. And Ibrahimovic really, really was a clinical striker. He finished everything in the area. I mean, he's got 90 shooting, so you'd expect him to just finish everything. He's 6'5" as well, so he wins everything in the air. He's also got 86 physical, 85 dribbling, which is very good. 81 passing as well is great. 73 pace is not bad either. And 4-star skills and 4-star weak foot, a same as a lot of the other players in the team. But yeah, he was a very good player. A lot of fun to use. He's very strong. He'll push people off the ball. If only he had 5-star skills, he would just be even better. But for some reason, he does not have 5-star skills, despite being a very, very skillful player in real life. But this is the finished team. Now, I really liked the defense because I had one relatively quick, very good at defending centre-back right here, but who had medium-high work rate, so he'd stay back. Then I had Naldo, who was just a massive player in the air. He'd win every header, and he's just a massive tank, really. He is very, very big in-game. You will see, if you do use him, just how big he is. He's 6'6", but he's also very wide, and it's almost as if he has kind of a ring around him, and if someone gets into that ring, they're not going to be getting past him, because if you just spam B, he's just going to be able to push them off the ball, and no one is going to get past him. Dani Alves and Zuniga, very, very good going forwards, and very, very good defensively. They're probably the two best attacking fullbacks that you can use, and I love good players, and that is what I've done right here. Now, moving into the midfield, we start off in the right defensive midfield position with Luka Modric. In my opinion, he is probably the best centre mid on the game, and as a defensive midfielder, he is also very good. He got me 2 assists in 4 games, and looking at his stats, he's got amazing stats. 89 dribbling, 84 passing, and also good pace and really, really good shooting as well. He's got great long shots, 4-star skills, 4-star weak foot, and yeah, he is probably my favourite centre mid on the game. He's amazing at passing, one of the best kind of creative midfielders I've used on this game. In the left defensive midfield position, we've got Daniel Rossi. I used him in an unbeatable 10,000 coin team that I did do yesterday, and he's an amazing defensive midfielder. He's actually become one of my favourite defensive midfielders on the game. He's got medium-high work rate, 6'1", and just defensively, he's amazing. He's got great defending and great physical. He's very cheap as well, and he got me 3 goals there in 12 games. In the middle of the pitch, we've got Kovacic. Now, he's 78 rated. He's a low-rated player, really, for a 100k team, but he is a very, very good player, and that's why he is in the team. Now, a lot of people actually prefer him to Modric, and I know Nepenthes especially really, really likes using him. He rates him as one of the best centre mids on the game, and in my opinion as well, he's an amazing player. One of my favourite cheap centre mids. I mean, he's very, very similar to Modric. He's quicker, he's not got the shooting, but he's got very, very similar passing and dribbling stats. He's got 4-star skills and 4-star weak foot as well, and medium work rate is very, very good for a centre mid in this position, because he's just going to stay there and be a very good kind of pivotal player that you can pass to. He's going to really distribute the play and be a very, very good player in that position. And